What is happening, guys? Cold View Black Ops Kid here, coming at you with a Battlefield 5 review. Now, we've played the campaign, multiplayer, and we're going to be talking about the vicious cycle of Battlefield 5. Now, of course, there's going to be a lot of new things that are coming out, DLCs and everything else like that, but we're going to be talking about the state of the game as of right now. So, obviously, the game doesn't have this Battle Royale mode up until February, but that is, of course, you know, something that will come out later with the game, so we can't really officially review the full thing of the game. Multiplayer is, of course, amazing. Six different map modes and can be played across eight different maps, up to 64 players, which is indeed the lowest amount of players that are in a Battlefield game up to date. There's also only four people in the squad, you know, obviously Conquest. There's also just recurring modes that have happened in the original Battlefield games. I like playing Team Deathmatch, but I of course like Conquest because you get tanks, planes, all this other stuff. Comparison to Battlefield 5 to Battlefield 1, Battlefield 5 has a lot more vicious animation. It's obviously a little bit more crisper with graphics. Visually, it's stunning. It does remind me of like Battlefield or Battlefront 2 from the Star Wars games that DICE also does. But it also refines and makes minor improvements to the chaotic and vast battlegrounds that it's known for. So it kind of like from Battlefield 1 to Battlefield 5, it does make quite an improvement. Of course, weapons are a lot more sturdier. There's more varied variety of weapons in this game. Obviously, with Battlefield, you can blow a hole in a building and clear out enemy objectives and stuff like this, which of course you can't do in pretty much any other game. At launch, I did see quite a bit of bugs, but I never got to really record any of the glitches that I had to run that would potentially ruin a match. You know, glitches that had aiming from turrets and other things like that, detaching your gun from your characters, your arms just floating, people T-posing, having things like objects being suspended in midair. There's just a lot of this stuff. I just wish I would have been able to capture more of this stuff. They did a lot of customization in this game, pretty much camos, scopes, customization with your characters. Of course, this is pretty cool. I like how everything affects the everything that will affect the stats of your gun. You do get start off with some pretty decent scopes right off the back instead of having to unlock them through kills. It's actually really nice. You know, I haven't really played a whole lot of the multiplayer, and this is probably where the game really sticks out. Obviously, they do have like customization that are filled through company coins, and you know, you can get these by unlocking and leveling up, but I feel like this is more of like Battlefield 5's accumbens to trying to do microtransactions like the recent games. The story has multiple story missions just like Battlefield 1, has people like trying to liberate France, and you know, people in the Axis forces. It doesn't have things that are like the usual breaches of Normandy, that kind of stuff. They're pretty short chapters, and there's not really a whole lot to talk about them. I didn't really care. They're very linear. They're now open, kind of like the original Battlefield 1, like the Arab ones. It's very loose. There's not really anything particularly amazing about the campaign. Just lots of stretches of land that are devoid of, you know, enemies or structures. It doesn't really give you that absence of World War II, and it just feels really, really boring. Of course, multiplayer is what everyone's going to be going to. The diverse weapons like M1 Grands, bolt action rifles are all in this game. And, I mean, honestly, I haven't really had a lot of time to play it. I've been very busy with other aspects and other things and ventures right now. So, I mean, until Battle Royale comes out, I'm not going to be putting a whole lot of time into this game. But I will say multiplayer is actually a pretty breath of fresh air. It's not, you know, a copy and paste of the original Battlefield 1, which is nice. And it's the one thing, the graphics are extremely amazing, especially on Xbox One X standards. The game does really stand out visually. And I just wish there was more maps, because there's not very many maps in this game as well. Of course, DLCs will come out with the game, adding to its variety of maps and stuff like that. But pretty much with everything given here, gameplay-wise, campaign is very, very boring. Multiplayer is pretty fun, a brush of fresh air, a lot of new tactics. Visually, it's amazing, breathtaking, destructible buildings as always. DICE has always been a really good one with this one. And lots of new variety weapons-wise. Better than, I would say, Battlefield 1. And, of course, with DLCs, it's going to make the game a little bit better. But right now, it kind of feels incomplete. And it's not really full, ready for launch. And I kind of think they rushed it. I mean, it was originally supposed to come out in October, I do believe, or alongside with Call of Duty, and they pushed it back farther. So, of course, with all this information, giving it kind of an incomplete game, no third mode like a Call of Duty, I give this game a 6.7 out of 10, and it kind of is a kind of disappointing campaign. Like, honestly, Battlefield 1 wasn't bad, but Battlefield 5 just kind of fell short when it comes down to this one. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. Do you guys agree? If you guys want to see more reviews of any games, Battlefield 5, I did leave a Fallout 76 review here. And we're going to be going back to original videos after this week, because we've been really busy playing other games and reviewing other content. So thank you guys so much for watching. I will appreciate the subscribe, like on the video. Comment if you guys are liking Battlefield 5. Also drop the gamer tag for either PlayStation 4 or Xbox One. And I will see you guys in the next one. Peace out.
Objective Charlie is ours. We have taken Objective Able.